tonight's concert featuring the... What? Oh. Is it on?
It's not on.
Thank you and welcome to tonight's concert featuring the 7th grade band and the 9th grade band. Our first song you heard, Blue Note Rock, is a composition with a little different sound for a 7th grade band, borrowing the sound from pop music with the model melody and rock feel combined to create a fresh approach. We will continue a piece by Stuart Glazer, which taught us how to start reading in cut time and how to follow the musical roadmap with first and second endings, Del Segno, and jumping to the coda. Here is Winterscape.
Inspired by their masterful work, The Planets, by Gustav Holst, this original piece pays homage to the dramatic first movement. Using only 6 notes in all instruments, the music has the powerfully ominous quality of Mars that has enwrapped generations of listeners with bold, majestic melodies and rhythmic ostinatos.
The beginning ostinato during the first 2 measures begins to evolve as various sections add layers of introduction, layers of sound. Following the basic form of Holst's masterpiece, the introduction becomes very powerful before moving into a softer and more lyrical section. With the ostinato staying present, the height of the piece is reached as the full brass and low woodwinds perform the menacing theme. Underneath the continuing ostinato and the high woodwinds, the work ends as the ostinato is broken and the music slows down dramatically, echoing the ending of the original. Here is Bringer of War.
That clock just doesn't sound right. Poking musical fun by tipping the sands of time. This Leroy Anderson classic theme is certain to bring a smile to all. Mr. Anderson was the composer for the Boston Pops Orchestra for many years, and his work became quite famous. Tonight you will hear Mr. Anderson's work, Syncopated Clock, redone for the middle school students. Listen to the percussion section and all the special toys they used in this arrangement. Here's the audience-pleasing arrangement by Robert W. Smith of the Syncopated Clock.
Our next piece is a holiday favorite that was released by Bobby Helms in 1957. This song can still be heard today during the holiday season. Here's our version of Jingle Bell Rock.
I have to say something. All right, before our final piece, I want to take time to thank all the students here in seventh grade band. They've come a long way from last May. So if you remember that concert. I remember all the compliments they got last year. I'm sure you'll get just as many as tonight when you go home, too. So, with this larger group, I do want to say that it's quite loud, too. I know. I'm sure you can hear that. They're a very strong group. So, I do want to thank you, the parents, friends, and family who do support all of the students that are here tonight in their music education. I want to like to thank John Justed back there for the sound and lighting. Bo Plant for setting up all of our lighting cues for this evening, so thank you very much. To all of our administration for keeping the importance of music education in the schools. To my music colleagues, Regina Romhild, Rachel Holte, Katie Beitart, Rhonda Card, Tyler Corby, and Kevin Huseth for all the hard work that they put in for the students, sharing your musical abilities. And after our final song now, I'm going to please welcome the ninth grade band after this song and under the direction of Kevin Huseth. And all right, they'll be coming up shortly. Take it away, Zoe. It's your turn.
We will finish our portion of tonight's concert with the piece that is set to the novel of the traditional carol Good King Wenceslas, which will musically transport you to the royal Christmas banquet hall of a medieval king. The old carol tells the story of a legendary 10th century monarch, Duke Wenceslas of Bohemia, who went out in the severe cold to give charity to the poor on December 26th, also known as St. Stephen's Day. The well-known 13th century carol tune, as well as additional original material in period style, vividly conjures a lively celebration of Christmas in the High Middle Ages. Here is at the Feast of Stephen.
The bel pavane is a type of slow professional dance that was often used in Europe during the 16th century. Originally, this piece entitled The Bel Pavane was published by Tilman Susato for a collection of Renaissance dance music way back in 1551. As of recent years, this arrangement by Bob Margolis has gained massive popularity as a piece for high school wind bands throughout the country. As you listen, you almost picture that you are in the mid-16th century court.
Three Songs of Bengal portrays the culture studied by its arranger, Akash Mittal, during his time in West Bengal. The three-movement piece features songs from the Hindu composer Rabindranath Tagore, Muslim composer Kazee Nazrul Islam, and a song from an anonymous composer of the Baul tradition. Developing thousands of miles away from the West, we were introduced to new scales and sounds, experience a glimpse into the diverse Bengali region in Three Songs of Bengal. Yeah.
This next piece, entitled Chasing Sunlight, is meant to invoke feelings of warmth, emotion, and comfort as you picture a setting sun. As you listen, you'll hear a sense of grandiosity as well as a sense of urgency that is representative of the chasing those last bits of sunlight before the sun disappears behind the horizon. Hence the title of the piece. For this one, please welcome our student teacher from UMD, Mr. Mortensen. He has been working with us since mid-October to fulfill his music education degree, and he will now be conducting this next piece.
So I had this amazing, heartfelt speech of thank yous to give you all, and then Mr. Hansen stole every single one of them. Thanks, Mr. Hansen. We'll see. I want to echo what Mr. Hansen said, though. There are incredible things happening up on this stage. I absolutely love what I'm hearing. It is so much fun. But this doesn't happen without an awful lot of support. It happens with support here at the school. It happens with support at home. It happens with support everywhere, you know? So a huge, huge thank you to our administration, Dr. Carey, Mr. Battaglia, Mr. Brenner, Mr. Prosen, everybody who insists on music being a part of the school day. That doesn't happen everywhere, and it happens here, and I think we see the results of it right here. Also a huge thank you to my teacher colleagues, Mr. Hansen. You know, I get to work with these kids every day, and they're amazing. But this is all Mr. Hansen's work. I have the easy part, so it's pretty awesome. And also, obviously, to Bo and William Bauer. I don't know if he's back there. William Bauer also put in a lot of effort to design these lighting cues. This is kind of a new little addition to our band show that we're pretty excited about, to be able to use this beautiful auditorium in this way. So I hope it's worthwhile for you all. Give us feedback. Oh, here you go, Bo. We want more of it. And finally, like Mr. Hansen said, thank you to our students. Every single day, I count myself the luckiest person on the face of the planet because I get to laugh, I get to feel proud, I get to make amazing art, I get to make a difference in people's lives, and I get to work with these students every single day, and I could not be more happy. So thank you all. Anyways. So. Over to Ava and Mr. Mortensen.
Portrait of a Clown from the well-known composer Frank Ticelli starts off with an upbeat, bouncy melody that is sure to get caught in your head. The song follows an ABA form with a short introduction and coda. As you listen to this opening melody, you can almost picture a clown bouncing around, laughing and telling jokes. Then in the middle, as it enters the B section, you'll hear the music become smoother, more flowy, and melancholy, giving a picture of a sad clown before it returns to its joyful A section from the beginning, truly providing us with a portrait of a clown.